stir up your chamber pressure nominal.
Vehicle tower cleared, wind a pitch over. Propulsion reports first stage engines nominal. What a sight when the ground cameras at Stargate. We're flying at twice the thrust of the Saturn V heading to space. We're throttled down and throttled back up. Going through the period of maximum aerodynamic pressure. As the velocity increases, the density of the atmosphere is decreasing.
Max Q.
Lessening stress on the vehicle. The call out, Max Q now. Continuing to watch the first stage as we head downrange. Seconds into flight. Our next major activity is going to be set down of the first stage. Houston Tracking Station now acquiring the vehicle. With shutdown, we will get separation of Starship and Super Heavy and ignition of the Starship engines. When Starship separates, we light up six engines in a staggered sequence. If all goes well, those six engines will burn for almost 6.5 minutes. From Starship. And there's views of the Raptor engines on the second stage as we prepare for stage separation. Now, after stage separation, the first stage will flip and begin a boost back maneuver for landing in the Gulf. Continuing to fly, 2 minutes 40 seconds, let's get ready for main engine cutoff.
Boost engine cutoff.
Beginning the flip for stage separation.
Right now, we are awaiting stage separation, where Starship should separate from the Super Heavy booster.
Yeah, Kate, right now it looks like we saw the start of the flip, but obviously we're seeing from the ground cameras the entire Starship stack continuing to rotate. We should have had separation by now. Obviously, this is does not appear to be a nominal situation.
Yeah, it does appear to be spinning, but I do want to remind everyone that everything after clearing the tower was icing on the cake.
Vehicle.
Live view there of our control center at Starbase, which we refer to as Star Command. As we've said before, obviously we wanted to make it all the way through, but to get this far, honestly, is amazing.